Guys, just coming back at you. First, I just wanted to say, you know, I've got a lot of reaching out, a lot of comments from you guys concerning my family and passing of my son and all. And I just wanted to tell you guys, I appreciate it. I appreciate you guys, all the nice and kind things that everybody said. Is so many that just really haven't had time to individually respond, but I will get to that. As I said, you know, we're just trying to, you know, trying to make it, man. This whole situation has put us in a really tight situation all the way around, you know. And it was just, you know, everything coming at us at one point, and we really haven't had a chance to grieve. Like I said, you know, we lost our son on the 14th, and then we had to have services for him by the 22nd, literally 3 days before Christmas. And it was like a rush thing because Christmas is right around the corner, and then there was nothing available until after the holidays, and obviously we didn't want to have him sitting around like that. But at the same time, we were so rushed that we couldn't even deal with it. So we ended up having family ended up having family deal with a lot of that stuff. So, yeah, it was rough. Still is rough, obviously. And, man, unless you have to put your child to rest, you don't know. It's just something you won't understand. I know a lot of people, you know, saying that they, you know, some people say they understand, some people say, you know, they don't know what to say. But until you go through that, nothing else really matters, man. And I play so many things back over and over. Like I said, I had just, you know, seen him before I left, literally the day before, and I was already dealing with so much on the road, man. I was like, I should just stay home when I was home. And then to go out and loads end up being canceled and so many other different things were going on, and then that happened, it was like I should have stayed home. And when I got that phone call, man, my wife was so hysterical, I couldn't even make out what she was saying, you know, and then she was just screaming. And I mean, I'll never forget that. I think that haunts me more than anything, man. That blood curdling scream that she had when she called me. And when she finally was able to say what she had to say, it was just like time stopped, man. And she was asking me to help her, and she was by herself, and she just was screaming and just asking me to help her and to do something. And I never felt so helpless in my life, man. That's just something that will just, I think, will haunt me forever, man, because the way that she was just screaming, it was just like, I knew it was bad, whatever it was. And I didn't really have an idea because even during the first phone call, she couldn't even get it all out, you know. It wasn't until she called back after she calmed down a little bit, after she was after the hospital, that what had happened and transpired. But I mean, it's tough, man. You know, it's tough, and you know, all I have is, you know, to give me comfort is that last week we had a really good time together. Me and him had a really good time together. And I'm glad that I got to spend that time. I was home with them. And yeah, but I just wanted to give you guys a thank you for all the reaching out that you guys been doing. And we're just trying to pick up the pieces again, trying to make it. And yeah, I really don't have a whole lot to say. I mean, I'm just kind of in a stagnant place, man, and I'm trying to push forward. That's it. And we will, just like with everything, time heals all things. And I don't even think you ever really heal from something like this. I just think you learn to cope. But we're taking it day by day, and that's it. Nothing more, nothing less. Yeah, and I'm just trying to hold on, keep the doors open, and trying to make some money so that we can figure out our living situation, of what we're going to do. If we're going to just stay in the RV or whatever or what. I mean, right now we don't even really care, to be honest. We it's the last thing we're thinking about. So we're just making do what we got to do. And actually, I don't even know where wifey is. She got up and left out, and she's been out of the truck about an hour, so I need to figure out where she's going to. But hope you guys are safe out there, and I appreciate you guys checking up on your boy. It means a lot, it really does. Peace out.